Alright, welcome guys. This is Unit 9.1, Functions. Now, before we go through this unit, we want to go over a couple vocab problems or words that you might or might not know. Okay, so the first one is a relation. That is the association between an x and y value. An input will have an output. So input being our x, our output being our y. Okay, so that is our relation. A function, on the other hand, so every function is a relation, but not every relation is a function. Okay, and you'll kind of get to see why in a couple moments. But in a function, each x has only one y value, so each input, only one output. Okay, and domain and range. Domain, again, domain and range you might be a bit more familiar with. Domain being all the set of all x values, range being the set of all y values. Now, before I give you an example, again, a relation function can be represented in many, many ways, okay? So a couple ways that you are very used to is it could be an ordered pairing. This ordered pairing could be put in a table. So a table is another way that could be represented, okay? It could be represented in a graph, okay? An equation could also be represented. Of course, there is. You can also represent this in a diagram or a mapping diagram. Okay, so those are all the ways that we can represent a relation and a function. All right. So what's the difference? What's the difference between a relation and a function? Again, everything that you will encounter will be a relation. Okay. So again, a relation is an association between x and y values, so inputs and outputs. So A and B is a relation, okay? And in this case, A, 1 is going to 2, 2 is going to 4, 3 is going to 7. So this would be a relation and function. Okay? And again, each X having only one Y. Okay, so let's go on to B. Is B any different? Well, B looks different. Okay, so in this case we have 1 going to 3, 2, output of 5. 3 has an output of 4 and 5. So again, remember what we said about functions. Each x has only one y output. Okay, so this would be a relation, but it would not be a function. Okay, so we'll go over two more examples like this. Also, one thing I did want to add. This map can be represented as a set as well, which you'll see quite often. So what I mean by that is we have our set of x values would be 1, 2, and 3. And our set of y values in this case would be 2, 4, and 7. All right, so is C a function or not? So when it comes to this, 1 goes to 8, 2 to 12, 3 to 12, this would be a function. Okay, the reason being, and again, if you're confused, each x value cannot have more than one y value. Okay, so this would be a function. Let's go to D. 1 goes to 2, 2 to 7, and 3 to 8. So this would also be a function. Okay, each independent x value has a one y value. All right, so functions can be or generally are denoted by small letters like f, g, or x. Just and that's why you've seen sometimes you guys have seen in problems f of x, x being our input. Okay, question is what is our output? So if f notes the function from x, which is 1, 2, 3, 4, your outputs should be 3, 5, 7, and 9. And again, it's 1, 2, 3, 4 in respect to 3, 5, 7, 9. So they relate to each other. So 1 has an output of 3. The function of 2 has an output of 5. F of 3 has an output of 7. And F of 4 has an output of 9. Quick note. Again, another vocab word. These are called images. Okay, your outputs are called images. So in this case, 3, 5, 7, and 9 are your image, or the image of 1, 2, 3, and 4, respectively. All right, example 2. Example 2 says the function f is defined by f, where x is mapped to 2x squared plus 1 with domain, where domain is negative 1, 2, and 3. Find the image, so your output of set f. So again, not too bad. We just have to get used to the vocabulary and the notation here, but we're going to say f of what? Negative 1, our input. We input this into 2x squared plus 1. Well, what do we get? So 2 negative 1 squared plus 1.
We're going to end up getting what? 1, 2.
F of 2 is going to end up being
4, 4, and 8, we get 9. Then F of 3 finally is 2. 3 squared plus 1, 9, 18, this will be 19.
Okay, now how usually you want to put your answers is in set notation. So let's say our y values have an output or images of 3, 9, and 19. Alright, for example 3. Example 3 displays a diagram displaying what our inputs are, which is 4 and 2, and what our outputs are, 7 and negative 1, using the function contained in mx plus b. Okay? Now again, it might be a bit confusing, but it's actually not too bad. So we're using these x values, plugging them into the function of mx plus b, and this is what your outputs are. So the following question we have to answer is, the diagram shows part of the mapping function of x being mapped into mx plus b. What is the value of m and b? We have to take advantage of our inputs and outputs. So what we can say here is we have f of 2 being mapped into this function and getting the output of 7. So f of 2, that would mean m, plug in 2 for x, plus b. That would mean 2m plus b is equal to what? Well, if I plug in 2, I end up getting 7 as my output. All right, sorry about that, the light just went out. So the next thing we gotta do, so 2m plus b is equal to 7, that's what we get when we plug in 2. What do we get when we plug in 4? Output is negative 1, let's go ahead and plug it in. So 4m plus b, 4m plus b is equal to negative 1. What we have here is what we can use is simultaneous equations, which will be our next step to find what m and b represent. All right, when you guys do simultaneous equations, which I'll leave you guys to do, but you will end up getting m is equal to negative 4 and b is equal to 15. All right, at this point, we know what we need to input for the function. So we have negative 4x plus 15. So f of x is equal to negative 4x plus 15. All right, your next question asks you what is the image, so the image of 5 under f. Okay, image is not 5, but it's asking you what the image is when you input 5. So now we have f of 5 is equal to negative 4, input 5 plus 15. That would end up being negative 5. So f of 5, input 5, you get output of negative 5. All right, for C, C tells us what is the element whose image is 3. So image meaning the output is 3. We have here is f of x, and rewrite our equation, 4x plus 15. Well, f of x, our image, is 3. Okay, and we have to figure out what our x value or our input is. Minus 15, so negative 12 is equal to negative 4x. X is equal to 3. So here is your following practice problem. It does have two parts, A and B. Make sure you answer both. Okay, we'll see you guys tomorrow.